Hello guys, welcome back to the channel. In today's video, I'm going to show you guys how to go ahead and buy coins on your Dust wallet using pancakeswap. Okay, so if you're actually new to the YouTube channel, guys, consider hitting the subscribe button and also don't forget to leave a like on this video. Okay, so as you can see right now, I'm on my phone. I'm using an iPhone. So I'm going to show you how to go ahead and buy coins, various type of coins, using your Trust Wallet. Okay, so the first thing you want to do, guys, is to open your Trust Wallet. And once you have your Trust Wallet opened, this is what your Trust Wallet is going to look like. Okay, so I'm going to take my phone and show you what it actually looks like. So you can see this is what your Trust Wallet actually looks like. You're going to see this section. You're going to see the wallet. You're going to see this. You're going to see wallet. You're going to see discover. You're going to see browser or d apps, and the last one you're going to see is settings. Okay, these are features you can actually go ahead and use. And in order for you to go ahead and purchase or buy on PancakeSwap, you need to make use of the browse feature or the d app feature. Okay, on your Android phone you're going to see the app, on iPhone you're going to see browser. Okay, so I'm going to click on the browser section. I'm going to click on the browser section, and once you click on the browser section, you're going to see this. You're going to see a search bar, and you can go ahead and input the PancakeSwap link. The link is actually going to be in my description below. So the link is pancakeswap.finance/app. Okay, so once you visit it, it's going to open. And remember, PancakeSwap, you can actually go ahead and buy coins on PancakeSwap using BNB. So you want to go ahead and change that to BNB. Okay, so it's still loading. Okay, so my network is somehow slow, so I'm going to pause the video to when it's done. Okay, so once you're done with that, and once you visited the site, this is what you're going to see on your screen, my screen. As you can see right now, it's going to say PancakeSwap wants to connect to your wallet, and you're going to click on connect. Okay, so I'm going to click on the connect button. So once you click on the connect button, you're going to see this. Okay, sorry, so I think this is, I'm actually visiting the wrong link. So I'm going to go back to PancakeSwap home page. And okay, so now from the back of PancakeSwap home page, I'm going to click on trade now. Or you can actually go to pancakeswap.finance, and from there you'll be able to click on the trade now. Okay, so I think it's meant to be pancakeswap.finance/app. I don't know why it's not going through. Okay, so right now I'm going to visit this, and you can see it's saying I should connect my wallet. So I'm going to collect my wallet, and now my wallet is connected. So as you can see right now, we've successfully opened PancakeSwap. Okay, the next thing we want to do, guys, is to go ahead and buy coins on PancakeSwap. Okay, so once you want to buy coins on PancakeSwap, you're gonna see two options. You're gonna see the first option, the first section you're gonna see is BNB, and section option you're going to see is cake. Okay, so for the first option, or the first box, this is the section you're going to select the currency you want to pay with. So currently you make use of BNB, so you're not changing that. You're going to be buying in BNB with BNB, so make sure you have some amount of BNB in your wallet. And the next token you're actually going to input the token you want to buy is this cake section. You click on it, then you can actually go ahead and search for the token you want to buy. Okay, so if you don't know the token, or if you're trying to search for the token and you can't find the token on your list, what you need to do is to paste the contract address of that token, paste it right here in the search section, and you'll be able to get that token. Okay, once you paste the contract address, so right now I don't have any contract address to search for, so I'm just going to select a random token right here on my PancakeSwap. Okay, let's say for example I want to go ahead and buy USDT with BNB. I'm going to select USDT, and once I select USDT, it's going to show, as you can see, USDT selected. So the next thing I want to do is to input the amount of BNB I want to swap to USDT. So I'm going to put in 0.10, and this is going to give us the amount of USDT. As you can see right now, if I have 0.10 one BNB, I'm gonna get 21 USDT. And remember, USDT is equivalent to US dollar. Okay, so right now, as you can see, and slippage is set to 0.5. If you want to go ahead and adjust your slippage based on, let me say, for example, if you're actually trying to purchase a new token, that's actually listed, most of them have slippage tolerance. So you go ahead and set their slippage tolerance from maybe 0.1 to 0.5 or 1.0. Okay, so right now it's set to 0.5. I can change this to 0.1, but I'm going to leave it as default in 0.5, and I'm going to click on that. And now I can click on connect wallet. So I'm going to select my wallet. So currently I'm using Trust Wallet. So I can search for Trust Wallet. I'll search for Trust Wallet, and it's going to connect. So now I'm saying I have insufficient BNB. This is because I don't have any BNB in my wallet, so I won't be able to go ahead and purchase this. Okay, so once you've purchased that token, most of the time when you actually purchase a token, you might not actually see that token in your wallet. What you need to do, guys, is to go back to your Trust Wallet, come back to the wallet section. Then once you're in wallet section, what you want to do, guys, is to tap on this icon right here. Tap on this icon right here. Then you can go ahead and check or search for it. Okay, so I can search for BNB. So once I search for BNB, as you can see right now, let's say for example it's turned off. For example, I can go ahead and turn it off and turn it on and turn on wrapped BNB. So right now, as you can see, it's turned on my Trust Wallet. So I can click on done, and if you scroll down, you notice that I have wrapped BNB enabled on my Trust Wallet. Okay, so let's say for example, if the token is not available on your Trust Wallet, let's say for example, if the token is a new token and you search for the token name and you can't find it here on Trust Wallet, what you need to do is to paste that contract address. Okay, once you paste that contract, you paste the contract address, you're gonna get add a custom token, or you can click on this plus icon to add a custom token. Okay, so this way you're going to select, make sure you select your network. Most of the time you can make use of BNB, then paste in the contract address, the name, symbol and this mouse is going to be imputed automatically. Then you can click on save, and once you click on save, that is going to complete, and you're going to see it at the end of your Trust Wallet. Okay, and as you can see right here, since I'm using an iPhone, at the end of my Trust Wallet I can also click on add token and it will take me directly to this section. Okay, and I can also click at the top of this, I can click on this filter icon, look at the filter icon, and it's going to take me directly to the section. Okay, so that's pretty much it, guys, on how to go ahead and buy coins on Trust Wallet using PancakeSwap. Okay, so if you actually enjoyed the video, guys, consider giving this video a thumbs up, and also don't forget to leave a like on the video. Thanks for watching, bye for now, and see you guys in another video.